Yo, what is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to another edition of Extra Vision. I'm your host, Eckstein, and we got a bunch of TF2 related news for you today. Let's get right into it. Coming up in less than 2 weeks is the I-46 land in Telford, England. We are so stoked for this. It is going to be an awesome event. XTV and our fundraiser has funded two teams to fly over from North America to compete at this land, and it's going to be the sickness. We couldn't have done it without the Multiplay organization. We want to give a huge shout out to them for supplying the XTV staff with press passes, as well as giving free tickets to all 12 team members that will be attending from North America. Definitely a huge help to us and our efforts to make this land happening. And primarily spearheading that is Tapley, so I want to give a huge shout out to him. He also just had his birthday last week, so big ups to him. Looking forward to meeting him in person. Now, the week after I-46, the Dota 2 International is going to be happening. That's going to be a sweet event, of course, supported by Valve, and getting plenty of press and attention from everybody. And this event put on by the community and, of course, I-46 Multiplay, is huge for TF2, and it's not really getting a whole lot of love. I've been super busy at work, but have been meaning to email some gaming news journalist websites and spread the word about this event. So if anybody out there wants to help me in this cause, this quest to get this event a little bit more coverage, I would deeply appreciate that. Now let's move on to competitive news. ESEA had their first week of action, some intermediate matches, invite matches starting next week. And let's take this opportunity to jump into a new segment, Match of the Week. This segment put together by Dr. Shadow Puppet. Take it away, Alex.
Hey guys, Dr. Shadow Puppet here with the very first edition of ExtraVision's Match of the Week. At the time of recording, there weren't many matches to choose from, but that doesn't mean quality is lacking in my pick, Tim Lays the Pipe versus PsyOps. These two ESEA Intermediate teams duked it out for over 45 action-filled minutes on CP Gullywalk. My player of the match has got to be You Must Mike, who racked up an incredible 50 kills. You heard right, guys, 50 kills. You can get the stats and the download to watch Mike and his team fight the good fight by clicking the link below the video. My pick for next week's match to watch is Mihai's Flow versus Leviathan Gaming. The newly reformed roster of Mihai's Flow has a lot to prove this season. With land spots up in the air, a close game here can mean that the new lineup is ready to take names and turn heads all season long as they vie for that coveted trip to Dallas later this year. Click the link below to find out more and to stay tuned to see if Mihai's Flow has what it takes. That's it for me on this episode of Match of the Week. Tune in next time for more recaps and replays only on ExtraVision.
Alrighty, thanks for that segment, Alex. And now let's take a look at some of the other competitive news. The ETF2L Nations Cup still going on very strong. The 6v6 format section of this event, they're doing both Sixes and Highlander. 6v6 is in the Sweet 16 stage. A few more teams might be knocked out by the time this episode airs. The Highlander portion of the event just reached the finals. Germany beat Sweden and France beat Finland in the semifinals broadcasted by Vanilla TV last week. It's been a crazy awesome tournament so far. A ton of viewers turning out, and there's also a $1,200 prize pot for the Sixes and a £1,200 prize pot for the Highlander teams, both put forward by some very generous donors, making this excellent European event just be that much more exciting. Also going on around the globe, Esquilado.com is hosting a TF2 tournament for South American TF2 players new to the competitive scene. 8 experienced players will captain their own teams, and then those teams will play for prizes. First place gets 6 bill hats, second place 12 keys, and third place gets 12 refined medals. Signups have already ended, unfortunately, but please show your support and watch and follow along with this event. The Brazilian TF2 community has been having a tough time lately, needs some love and support in order to survive and keep growing. They've been getting hit with DDoSes, denial of service attacks, and we all know that's just some jackass trying to ruin your fun. So please stay on the right path and keep playing, players. Going on back to North America, UGC Season 8 announced starting September 9th. The big, huge news is now there is no invite limit for the Platinum Division. This is very exciting news. The other divisions will still have a 3-invite player limit, but the Platinum Division now going to offer the top level of competition that Highlander is really capable of. Basically, any of the Sixes players that were still complaining about Highlander not being serious because they couldn't form a super team have now been shut up because they are forming super teams. So it's going to be very interesting to see how this next season of UGC plays out, if teams can stay together. But the level of competition is going to be fierce. You guys are going to have to tune in to XTV to find out just how these invite-laden teams do. Now, let's move on to letters to Robin. Dear Robin, we got word that the Valve software community is playing an internal Dota 2 tournament. Instead of the international, you guys are calling it the internal. We think this is very cool. Of course, maybe there was some hints that maybe people could watch it. Of course, we would love to watch it, you know, but that's cool. You guys can play in private. But I would just like to encourage you guys to have an internal Team Fortress 2 tournament. Maybe play some Highlander, some Sixes, whatever. The format doesn't even matter. But it would be great to have the entire Valve software company get involved with some Team Fortress, enjoy the fun of it, and also maybe discover a few of the roadblocks that the competitive community faces every day. Thanks, Robin. Next time. And now for our item of the week. The item of the week is the Medical Nemesis by Bang. It's a pretty sweet medic set. It's got a new healing gun, it's got a new backpack, and then it's also got a laser gun called the Precision Cutter, which could perhaps be the first truly inspired gun from the lightning gun of Quake, a very famous gun and something that has been lacking in the Team Fortress series for a while. Also, a pretty sweet melee item called the Cardiac Arrest. It's going to shock you. So definitely cool stuff, and we hope that it gets included in the game at some point. Now let's talk about some of the TF2 updates going on. XTV staffers wanted me to re-mention the new matchmaking that was dropped in, a way to find servers with your friends. Definitely high hopes from the competitive community that this feature will get further fleshed out, but at the same time already has great implications, and there are many other implications of what it will develop into. What people wanted me to mention that I forgot to mention last time around, at the bottom of the Triad Pack website, they hyped a new cough map that seems to use a city architecture theme, which looks very styling, and it's gonna be called Kong King. Very cool stuff. And then also just today, filmed on Thursday, there was a new secret page added on the teamfortress.com website. A little blood splatter showed up. If you click on that, you get to see one of those classic man letters dropping some more TF storyline and hyping a third Zepediah man son, curiously named Gray. So I just want to say that Valve knows how to build up hype. Somebody went back to the Christmas update and noticed that on the Christmas tree, there's a balloonicorn ornament hanging off the tree. So certainly Valve knows how to drop hints and to build up that hype train. Let's get that rolling. Now, let's move on to the community of the week. Our community of the week is the Late Crew, a great group of ballers who just hang out and have fun and play on some servers. They are helping out with the XTV pub servers, which I suggest you check out, xtelevision.com/servers, as well as having their own Chicago stock server and a New York team deathmatch server. These guys play all sorts of games and hang out with each other in the XTV mumble. Also have helped us organize some events in the past, including the most recent MGE tournament, as well as the Ulti Duo tournament in the past. So big ups to those guys. That pretty much does it for us in this edition of Extra Vision. Want to hype up our streaming schedule next week. Time's not really set at this point, but we certainly want to broadcast that classic mix-up versus Leviathan Gaming match on CP Goalie Watch. It's going to be amazing. And then we're going to be trying to throw some other stuff in there. We've been working on getting our scheduling more down, so please join our Steam group. Tune in our website to get the most latest information. Also want to give a shout out to districtlines.com for this Yao t-shirt. You can get your very own Yao t-shirt or Pop It, Don't Drop It, or huge air shot. So check that out, districtlines.com/XTV. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. Keep on playing, players. I'm X-Dine. I'll see you next time. Peace out.